Hello dear students, welcome to the third and final part of this series on the Heisenberg Uncertainty Principle. So what do we know about this principle from our earlier discussions? We have seen that the values of two conjugate variables cannot be simultaneously measured with infinite accuracy for a microscopic particle. The product of uncertainties in the simultaneous measurement of conjugate variables always has a value above h cut by 2. Coming up on the screen are the three equations, or rather inequations, which mathematically show the Heisenberg uncertainty principle in terms of position and momentum. If we talk in terms of energy and time, the Heisenberg uncertainty principle looks like so. And in terms of the angular position and angular momentum, this is the inequation for Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. These are the things that we have already discussed in our earlier videos. Now we have to discuss what makes this principle so important. The uncertainty principle, in fact, is one of the most famous and misunderstood ideas in physics. When we think about Newtonian universe, where everything follows clear-cut laws on how to move, where to be, and their prediction is also very easy if one knows the initial conditions, here comes the quantum mechanical principle given by Heisenberg, which brings in a new concept of uncertainty or vagueness. So, this uncertainty principle formally limits the precision to which two conjugate variables can be measured. It also establishes that phenomena can take on a range of values rather than a single exact value. This necessitates a probabilistic interpretation of the behavior of matter on the molecular level and statistical mechanics to explain the aggregate behavior of molecular and atomic systems as they give rise to macroscopic properties and behaviors. So, the uncertainty principle changes the perspective about fundamental physical principles. We have consequences in the interpretation of physical phenomena on all length scales. It is not so important with respect to the empiricism in the everyday world, but is an integral idea in connecting behavior within the population of an atomic or molecular system and the observable properties of that system. For further studies, you may go through the following links. I will also mention them in the description box. Now let's see where this principle can be applied in nature. Consider atoms. Negatively charged electrons orbit around a positively charged nucleus. By classical logic, we would expect opposite charges to attract each other and stay together. That is, electrons would stay within the nucleus. But does that happen? Let's find out. According to the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, we know that delta x delta px is greater than or equal to h cut by 2. Now, if you look into the picture of an atom, the nucleus has a radius of about 10 to the power minus 14 meters. If the electron has to stay within the nucleus, what would be its maximum position spread? Must be the diameter of the nucleus, that is 2 into 10 to the power minus 14 meters. Now, since we know the maximum spread of the position from Heisenberg uncertainty principle, we may calculate the minimum value of momentum of the electron in this scenario, the value of which you can see in this slide. Hence, this is the minimum momentum of an electron allowed as per Heisenberg uncertainty principle if it was staying within a nucleus. Now, what do we know about relativistic particles' energy? That the total energy of a relativistic particle can be expressed as E square is equal to P square C square plus M0 square C to the power 4. So for this electron, the minimum energy square would be the square of the minimum value of momentum into C square plus M0 square C4. Putting the values that we have already calculated and that of M0 and C, what we get is that the minimum energy of an electron if it stays within a nucleus is approximately 10 mega electron volts. So, if the electron were to stay within the nucleus, it should have minimum energy of 10 mega electron volts. However, what is seen in reality? Experiments like beta decay show that emitted electrons do not have more energy than 2 to 3 mega electron volts. And hence, electrons cannot exist within the nucleus. Isn't this picture strong enough to let us know that however the electron wants to stay with the proton and the neutron, it has to stay away from them? Now just think. This entire universe consists of atoms with electrons and nuclei. So, the entire universe wouldn't be like this, what it is now, without this principle. So, can you understand the significance of this Heisenberg uncertainty principle now? There are many more applications of this principle like this. Like size of hydrogen atom, its energy value, etc., etc. But I wouldn't elaborate more on the position momentum uncertainty since it will lengthen the video. However, I would like to talk about an application of the energy time uncertainty, which is the natural width of spectral lines. When an electron or atom transits from lower energy state to upper energy state, it remains there only for 10 to the power minus 8 seconds and comes back to the lower state after emitting electromagnetic radiation. So, for this process, we have the time spread to be only 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. So, from Heisenberg uncertainty principle relating energy and time, we can calculate the energy spread value. Putting the time value as 10 to the power minus 8 seconds, we see that the value of energy is not at all precise, but it is having a certain spread. Now, if the energy has a certain spread, and as energy is equal to the product of Planck's constant and frequency, the frequency also appears with a spread now. That is, since delta E is a spread over a value, due to uncertainty principle, the frequency also has a finite spread or width. And hence, the frequency spreads and gives a broad spectrum. So, instead of spectral lines being single crisp lines, we find them to be spread over a range or width, as seen in this picture. So, from the very first part of the video on this series to this particular slide, we have discussed a lot on the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, and I hope you all have understood the principle as well as its significance and importance. So, that's all I had to discuss about the Heisenberg uncertainty principle in this series. I would also like to tell all of you something. As we all know, we are going through an uncertain phase in our lives at this moment. But more we practice precautions and preventions, we can surely reduce the uncertainty of the COVID-19 spread. So let's apply the uncertainty principle here as well. And finally, my dear students, whatever may come, keep calm and love quantum mechanics. This is Esha ma'am signing off. Bye-bye.